طيب اوكي. I think the slides in this lecture a bit different from those that you have. السلايدات انا مغير الارنجمنت تبعتهم. So in the last lecture we talked about the shoulder joint and its relation to the scapular and the pectoral region. And we concluded by the end of that lecture that the scapular region helped the shoulder joint to rotate mainly. Those were the infraspinatus muscle. Of course, we talked about it. And then we talked about the also teres minor as a lateral rotator of the shoulder joint. Then we also mentioned that teres major has a important role in medial rotation as it sneaks under the joint to be inserted into the anterior surface of the humerus, exactly, precisely into the medial lip of the bicipital groove. By doing this, teres major, although it is coming from the posterior surface of the scapula, however, it performs medial rotation as it is shoulder joint plus a little bit of extension. We were not concerned about the rotation, whether it is lateral or medial, because the scapular region has provided us with all what we need. So the shoulder joint is done with rotation. We don't mind if there are other muscles that can also contribute to the rotation, but at least we have found some that can perform lateral rotation on the shoulder joint as well as medial rotation. Then the pectoral region has provided us with especially pectoralis major muscle with horizontally running fibers that were attached into the bicipital groove and clavicular head that is running vertically. Now the horizontally running fibers, and we did mention that this way the direction of the fibers determines the function of the muscle. So the pectoralis major muscle with its two heads, the horizontally running fibers, these fibers here, were of course adducting and medially rotating the shoulder joint. So adduction has been provided by the pectoral region, as well as to ensure medial rotation from the pectoral muscle as well. We were lacking as well this flexion. We didn't have any muscle that flexes the shoulder joint. The clavicular head, taking its origin from the medial part of the clavicle crossing in front of the shoulder joint, and I did mention that any muscle crosses in front of the shoulder joint certainly flexes the shoulder joint. So these fibers here are running in front of the shoulder joint and most likely flex the shoulder joint. So put all this together, pectoral region as well as scapular region, we ended up having muscles that rotate, muscles that adduct, and of course flex. However, we didn't mention extension in its wide range. Also, we have from the scapular region supraspinatus that initiated abduction until 15 degrees. So now we need to carry on. The shoulder joint needs an abductor up to 90 degrees. We need another flexor because the clavicular head is not enough. We may need also an extensor. So therefore, We went to look for different areas, and that is exactly something I would like you to understand. I would love you to understand that pectoral region is anterior, scapular region is posterior, and between them is this muscle, the deltoid. The pectoral region is anterior, the scapular region is posterior. What a genius design here, the deltoid muscle coming to fill this gap, okay? This muscle, the deltoid muscle, gives the shoulder joint its contour, its shape. And this muscle has a unique fibers that crossing the joint anterior to it, as in this one here. Anterior fibers crossing anterior to the joint, and any muscle crosses anterior to the shoulder joint would certainly flex it, and posteriorly running different fibers from deltoid, they would also extend. And in the middle here, as you can see, the middle fibers, they are similar, imitating the supraspinatus muscle, and therefore they are strongly enough. They can carry on abduction from 15 degrees up to 90 degrees. So I need you to consider the deltoid muscle as the connection between pectoral region as well as scapular region, completing the function of the shoulder joint. So the anterior fibers would flex, and I shall go back to the pectoral muscle here. Pectoralis major, this one. I have to draw here. And
دكتور؟
Yeah, okay.
يعني الدلتويد هي المسل الوحيدة اللي بتعمل حركتين opposite, الاكستنشن والفليكشن اكستنشن.
That is an excellent thing that you have noticed. You, doctor, gave us headache talking about that each muscle can perform only one movement on one axis, that is flexion or extension on this axis, for example. And there you go, here you're talking about deltoid muscle that can perform extension and flexion. This is the only example that we would consider that the muscle performs flexion and extension, and this is exactly to consolidate our understanding that the direction of the direction of the fibers determines. And the direction of the fibers determines here, the function of any given muscle, okay? So this is an exception, and I already mentioned that we do have some exceptions, and the deltoid muscle is the one to talk about. Now, the clavicular head of pectoralis major running, the fibers are running vertically, and these are here the anterior fibers of deltoid muscle. They're also similar to the clavicular head. So now we have two parts of different muscles that come together, and even we call them deltopectoral muscle, deltopectoral muscle, okay? And they are crossing anterior to the shoulder joint, and they are the main flexors of the shoulder joint. So the deltoid muscle, as you can see here, anterior fibers, they would complete the flexion, posterior fibers, they would complete extension, and for sure the middle fibers would complete abduction. One word about its origin. The origin, as you can see here, of this muscle, this is posterior. We are looking at the scapula posteriorly. The scapula has upper lip, the spine of the scapula, and lower lip. So the posterior fibers are taking their origin from the lower lip of the spine of the scapula. Then the middle fibers are taking their origin from the outer border of the acromion, okay? And of course, the anterior fibers taking their origin from the lateral half of the clavicle. This would be like similar to the English letter U. However, it is inverted to the side. So that is the origin. The insertion, it looks like a V here on the shaft of the humerus. We call it the deltoid tuberosity. So the origin and insertion should be easy, okay? Those fibers who crossing anterior to the joint would certainly flex it. Those on the opposite who are running behind the joint would certainly extend it, and leaving the middle fibers to complete abduction up to 90 degrees. Okay. Now, I think the arrangement of slides here are different from those you have. The question is, do we need any muscles for the shoulder joint? Do we need flexors? We have them from pectoral and deltoid muscles. Do we have extensors? Yes, we do. Maybe, I don't know. The teres major performed some sort of extension. The posterior fibers of deltoid, are they enough to support extension for the shoulder joint? It seems that they the extension needs support. And if we are talking here about extension, you need to understand that the muscle that extends the joint should be lying behind and superior to the shoulder joint or inferior. It doesn't matter as far as it crosses the shoulder joint. So if you look at this muscle, and the question is, why do we need it, this muscle? Okay, it is the latissimus dorsi muscle. Look at this muscle. It's a huge muscle. Though it is extensive, huge muscle, it is flat. Now, it takes its origin from T7. T stands for thoracic. We have cervical vertebrae, we have thoracic vertebrae, we have lumbar vertebrae. So it takes from T7. And by the way, each vertebra, I'm drawing the vertebra from lateral view, okay? Each vertebra has, you can certainly spot on, identify it from the lateral view. However, when you turn it as it is in this diagram, you would see only this is the spine, this is the spine. So the muscle here is taking the origin from the spine, which is نتوء spine. هون مش معناها الباك, معناها نتوء في الفقرات. Okay, all this is an origin. Then L1, L5, this area is the lumbar area. Okay, extensive origin. Then it takes also from the iliac crest. I didn't mention this, maybe thoracolumbar aponeurosis. And for sure, it touches on the inferior angle of the scapula. All this extensive origin, then it wraps up, it left, طلعوا كيف, and to be inserted where? Anterior to the shoulder joint. What does this mean? It is inserted into the floor of the bicipital groove. If we go back to the groove, bicipital groove, here, we have completed now all the muscles. Pectoralis major, teres major, this is M major, and this is M major, and between them, okay, latissimus dorsi, a lady between two men. If you just look at these three muscles, they have crossed this joint, and they all inserted anterior to the joint, and that's why their function could be medial rotation, and some of them would extend, and certainly tear is major, participating into the extension, lying posterior to the joint. And today we are talking about also an extensive muscle, اسمها latissimus dorsi. What is the main function or action of this muscle? Extends, adducts, and medially rotates humerus, like in canoeing or swimming. This is a muscle that supports the actions of on the shoulder joint. So I think that you need to put it this way. The pectoral region, the scapular region, have given the shoulder joint all its needed movements. Then it has been completed by deltoid and supplementary by the latissimus dorsi. Those are the muscles that are created and designed to act on the shoulder joint, okay? The nerve of the latissimus dorsi, it's a unique nerve, thoracodorsal nerve. We done with the shoulder joint. We don't have any other muscles that act on the shoulder joint. That's why I just shifted some of the slides to make you understand the story of the shoulder joint and how these muscles acting on the shoulder joint. Now, we do have something we call it shoulder girdle. This is not the shoulder joint, and the shoulder girdle is synovial joints, are synovial joints, the shoulder girdle joints, made of sternoclavicular joint and acromioclavicular joints. The question is, why do we need such a girdle? Why do we need these joints? The idea is very simple. Sometimes you're standing on your feet and you are in need to grab something from the cupboard. You may reach open the cupboard, but you can't reach forward the things that you need. And therefore, the genius design of the upper limb allows the scapula to move forward, and it's all about the scapula. So the shoulder joint has limited movement because it is combined by the head of the humerus and the glenoid cavity, and therefore it would be a genius design if you can move the shoulder joint itself completely forward. يعني بمعنى آخر الشولدر جوينت بيعمل 90 درجة فقط 90 degrees of abduction. طيب بدي أحط إيدي فوق راسي كيف بدي أعملها؟ I need to reach my other ear. I need to scratch my head, my skull. بدي أوصل لفروة الرأس. كيف بدي أعملها؟ أو أنا بدي أمسك إشي من الرف الأمامي. Therefore, the shoulder joint itself moves forward, backward, upward, downward. What do you mean by this? I'll explain it to you. Now, this is the scapula here. This is the scapula, okay. And this is the head of the humerus. Now, let's talk about simple abduction. Initiation of abduction, it's supraspinatus. Supraspinatus abducts the shoulder joint, okay, 15 degrees. So this is the movement of the shoulder joint, 15 degrees. Now, the middle fibers of deltoid would carry this into to become this way. Let's change the color. The head of the humerus would be like somewhere up to 90 degrees. That's it. Now, the shoulder joint now said to be blocked. What do you mean? If you just move your arm up to 90 degrees, the greater tubercle of the head of the humerus would come in contact with the acromion. So therefore, the shoulder joint can't perform any abduction above 90 degrees. That's impossible. But if you know, if you look at this, I can move my arm above 90. So this is what I'm talking about. And here I'll ask you a question. I'll draw this again here. This is the scapula here. Of course, the glenoid cavity, it's much, it's shallow depression, it's not deep, okay. And this is the head of the humerus, and that is the best we can do, 90 degrees. Now I'm asking you a question. If you wanna move this, the humerus, more than 90 degrees, like this, what possibly you can do? شو ممكن تعمل عشان تحرك الارم اكثر؟
Move the scapula.
Move the scapula up with it.
Excellent, excellent. And this is... Yeah, you will not be able to move this, but you will be able to move mean scapula. What do you mean? I mean this way. If I move the scapula this way, okay, the humerus also would be moving. So at the shoulder joint, it's 90, achieved by two muscles, supraspinatus, of course, the middle fibers of deltoid. Now, after that, I need to move the scapula, all right? So can we move the scapula? Yes, we can. Why? Because the scapula, although it is full of muscles, one of them has attached the scapula to the posterior wall of the thoracic cavity. ولا في أي عضلة مسكت الاسكابولا في العظم تبع الثوراسيك خلف. And therefore, the scapula can move freely up, down. It can rotate, medial rotation, outside, lateral rotation. To the back, to the vertebral column, medial rotation. We have names for these movements. Okay? So it's all about the scapula. If you can move the scapula, then you can move the arm. And this is an astonishing design of the upper limb. Therefore, you know that although the scapula is not attached to anything, it needs joints to move. مش عنا إشي بتحرك هيك. And therefore, we need to talk about the shoulder girdle. Before I proceed, you have to understand that put your hand on your acromion or imshi, feel the clavicle, it's subcutaneous, the clavicle until you reach your shoulder here. Now, try to grab something, mid idak lal amam, and you feel that the clavicle has been pushed forward. Now, do the opposite. Put your hand on the shoulder, in the lateral end of the clavicle, and try to grab something from behind you, okay? Now you feel that your clavicle has been depressed backward. Okay, go to the sternum here, with the clavicle, feel the clavicle, and go to the medial part of the clavicle, okay? This is the sternocleidomastoid. Repeat the same things, forward, backward, upward, downward. You feel under your fingers that the clavicle is moving. So we need to understand two things, that we have shoulder joint, ball and socket, that gives us a wide range of movements, flexion, extension, abduction, adduction, medial rotation, lateral rotation. But what if we need, in a certain dangerous moments in our life, to grab we're falling down from an unexpected accident, okay, and you need to grab for a stick. بدك تمسك بغصن. Okay. بدك تمسك بإشي. You need this extra genius design of the shoulder girdle that gives you the ability to move your arm a bit forward, move your arm a bit backward, move your arm a bit above 90 degrees. And this is achieved by these joints. They are very simple. I didn't ask you to know everything about them. This is the first one here. This is the medial end of the clavicle. We defined the joint as two bones becoming close to each other. And this is the this is B and this is EA. And they have a capsule, all right? And this is synovial joint. Sometimes inside the synovial joints, we may witness cartilage like this one, articular disc. This facilitates the movement of irregular surfaces between the articulating bones. We have it in the ulna as well. We have many of these articular discs in different joints. So this is a synovial joint, obviously. The sternal end of the clavicle, معمول بالsternal end of the clavicle, clavicular notch of the sternum. They have articular disc. Okay. What are the movements? Shul movements. Here we don't have rotation. We do have the clavicle. I may draw it like this as well here. The sternum. Okay. We need it to be pushed forward, backward, up. So here we don't have rotation, we have gliding movement. تتزحلق على بعضها, okay? تدفع للأمام, forward, backward, vertically, upward, or downward. We call it anteroposterior and vertical planes. It's much simpler than the shoulder joint itself. Here we go into details. Acromioclavicular joint. It is synovial joint, articulating surfaces, the acromial end of the clavicle, acromial margin, هي نفس الشيء, هي الأكروميون, مع مين؟ مع lateral end of the clavicle, عليهم capsule. This is a synovial joint, okay. Movements are anterior posterior, okay, and vertically up and down, okay, for these joints. This is the sternoclavicular joint. And this is the acromioclavicular joint. When you can move forward, you can move backward a little bit here, but the more important function, it would be seen here. How you move, you push your shoulder forward and backward, and of course, upward and downward. Here are examples of scapular movement. So, the question was simple. What if you need extra movement at your shoulder joint? The answer was we can't do this. But what we is to move the base of the shoulder joint, which is the glenoid cavity. How we can do this? By just rotating the scapula, elevating, depressing forward. So there are names for the scapular movements that takes place on the shoulder girdle, اللي هم elevation. When you've been asked here in Jordan, we may do this. No, this is in Jordan, it means no. You just elevating and depressing, elevating and depressing the shoulder joint. Okay, while you at home, just put your fingers on these areas and try to depress or elevate shoulder, and you would really feel that they are mobile. Now the question is, who will do this? Who will move the scapula? It is produced by the upper part of trapezius and levator scapulae. These muscles, we will leave them to the next year for musculoskeletal system. But the trapezius, I would talk about it just in seconds. Depression, it's sufficiently by gravity, but جاذبية بتنزل. Protraction, this is example, thrust. لما بترمي إيدك للأمام, boxing, whatever it is, reaching out for some stuff. This is protraction. أمد إيدي أكثر لمين للأمام, to reach out some stuff. طب ما هي flexion دكتور. لا, الفليكشن انت, that is flexion. Flexion, fix your shoulder joint and do complete flexion. Now you need to reach out. This is not enough. I need to go forward. Now I move my shoulder joint. You try it on yourself. The shoulder joint is moving forward. Explain it to me, please, Dr. Adi. The scapula slides on the thoracic wall, slides forward, giving the shoulder joint the ability to move forward. But this movement does not occur at any time at the shoulder joint. This movement, retraction, elevation, depression, it's all about the shoulder girdle. مفهوم؟ طيب, وحكينا هذا. والمسلز serratus anterior, هلا رح احكي عنها. وبكتوراليس minor, do you remember that I said leave pectoralis minor later? Because that was, we were talking about pectoralis major, and we were talking about the pectoral region. We talked about pectoralis major, and we should talk about pectoralis minor. But in the context, it was not related to the shoulder joint, because pectoralis minor, go to it. This is pectoralis minor. Insertion, origin. The shoulder joint, what do you think? شو رأيكو؟ هل قطعت هذه العضلة الشولدر جوينت؟
لا.
Oh no.
لا لا.
Would this muscle act on the shoulder joint?
Of course.
لا.
No. But we needed to talk about it as we go in anatomy, regional anatomy. Pectoralis major, pectoralis minor. So this muscle is acting on the shoulder girdle because this muscle didn't cross the shoulder joint. And it was hard for me to explain it to you. And that's why I left it for today's lecture, okay? So this muscle, pectoralis minor, it brings its insertion, heel insertion, towards its origin. What does this mean? It moves the scapula forward. What does this mean? Protraction, moving the scapula forward to reach. سقط مني القلم بدي أجيبه forward, يعني بغض النظر بدي أجيب إشي من الرف على الخزانة forward. Protraction, we call all this protraction, and now you should know the meaning of pectoralis major making protraction. Okay. Retraction, it is when you just move your shoulder backward. Muscles involved are trapezius and rhomboids. Rhomboidus muscle, these are also for the next year for the musculoskeletal system. Easy movements of the scapula. Lateral rotation, this is the lateral border, this is the glenoid. We know now this is the lateral border, okay? We can move the lateral border of outside or the medial border inside. Here we are talking about lateral rotation. This is an amazing description. You laterally rotate the scapula, but what you can see that you elevating your arm above 90 degrees. We just used and explained this rotation. When you gonna lateral rotate your shoulder girdle, the scapula on the shoulder girdle, when you just raising an arm above the head. Muscles involved, trapezius, serrates anterior, I will talk about them just in a second. Medial rotation, لما انت had this border, okay, you're taking it towards the vertebral column, our midline. Here is the midline. Don't you ever forget, this is the medial border, okay. Now, before I go into the muscles, that we don't have much time to finish. Obviously, you can see here, supraspinatus initiates abduction, 15 degrees. Middle deltoid, they go until 90, deltoid muscle, okay? Now, until this movement, we didn't reach 90 here, it's not 90. But the picture here trying to say that shoulder girdle, scapular movement, are taking place before we reach 90 degrees. Look, here the scapula still, it's in position, almost. Here, the scapula has rotated. Why? Because the middle fibers of deltoid, as they making abduction, the scapula is almost moving. So in living, what I'm trying to say that scapula won't stay still, يعني ما راح تضلها هيك ساكتة, until you reach 90 degrees. Rotation, abduction, as you begin abduction from 90, 15 degrees, the scapula would also go into rotation. So this is what we call scapulohumeral rhythm. Scapula and the humerus, they also have this rhythm between them. As the humerus moves, the scapula also would move. Of course, you can just, as you can see, this is read only. Now, we need to make sure, in these slides, I just explained to you shoulder girdle and the movements of the shoulder girdle, and that was as an answer to what if we need to scratch our heads, or what if we need to go further forward or further backward. Now we need to know the muscles acting on the shoulder girdle. In this context, I just changed the arrangement of the slides. Okay. Trapezius. Okay. This muscle has an extensive origin from the base of the skull. It is the only one here taking, and of course, cervical vertebrae. C stands for cervical. T12 vertebrae, and all the thoracic vertebrae. Okay, all this. So it is quite extensive muscle, and then it wraps itself and going down. We call these fibers are the upper fibers, inserting themselves, and middle fibers. Middle fibers are inserted themselves in the inner border of the acromion, and they are running horizontally. And lower fibers, they are inserting themselves in the lower lip of the spine of the scapula. So though trapezius looks like one unit, but you can easily follow the direction of the fibers, and you can easily put them into upper, middle, and lower fibers. And it goes without saying that you have learned the lesson now. You know that the direction of the fibers determines the function of these fibers. And most of you now expecting me to say that trapezius has three functions, because it has three different fibers in their direction. And this is absolutely true. But the insertion is that we need to talk about this. The insertion to the origin of deltoid. So buy one, get one free. Do you know this? You need to memorize the origin of deltoid. It is the lateral border of the clavicle. It is the outer border of the acromion and the upper lip of the, or the lower lip of the deltoid, of the spine of the scapula. Now, what you really need to know that the insertion of the trapezius is the opposite. It goes to the lateral one-third of the clavicle posteriorly. It goes to the inner border of the acromion and to the upper lip of the spine. So here you need to just memorize the origin of deltoid, and opposite to it is the insertion of another muscle called trapezius. Now, my question to you is a very simple question. What do you think? Does this muscle cross the shoulder joint? شو رأيك؟ هل قطعت هاي shoulder joint؟
No.
No.
Excellent. No. So, does this muscle act on the shoulder joint?
No.
Certainly no. So, and therefore, the question is, for a produce a movement, it has to cross over a joint. What do you think? This muscle crosses or acting on which joint? No. You need to understand that acromioclavicular and sternoclavicular joints, they act together. If you move one of them, the other would move. This is plane gliding, okay? They are connected to each other. The one can't move without the other one sitting and waiting, okay? So this muscle would act on the shoulder girdle. Scapular? Yeah, on the shoulder girdle. شو يعني scapular movement. خلينا نشوف. لكن trapezius does not move on its own. There is an orchestrated movement. في حركة متناسقة مع عضلات ثانية خصوصا serratus anterior. Controlling the during movement fibers of the scapula elevate scapula. Sorry. هاي الاسكابولا هيك مش هم the insertion of the trapezius is in the spine of the scapula and the acromion of the scapula, صح؟ But therefore, قرب الانسيرشن, bring the insertion towards the origin. The movement is elevation of the scapula. So upper fibers of trapezius, they elevate scapula at which joint? At the shoulder girdle joints, sternoclavicular, acromioclavicular. Okay, just they push elevating your shoulder. Middle fibers usually middle fibers pull scapula medially. قرب الانسيرشن bring the insertion towards the origin. You are bringing the shoulder towards the mid line. Okay, هيك. جيب لما بتجيبهم للداخل و lower fibers هدول these fibers here okay medial border or pull the medial border okay of the scapula downward and this is very important here. We need to just keep it in your mind that trapezius, they can rotate or pull the medial border of the scapula downward. We finished talking about the trapezius. I would carry on talking about it just in seconds with combination with serratus anterior. Now this muscle is unique in its shape. شكلها بجنن. شكلها trapezoid. يعني شبه معينية الشكل. It is huge and extensive. It has reached the skull, the cervical vertebrae, thoracic vertebrae. Then the insertion is amazing as they wrap down and get themselves inserted against or opposite to the origin of a deltoid. By doing this, we have ended up having three directions, three fibers with different directions, upper elevating the scapula, middle pulling it medially, and the lower can rotate the medial border of the scapula. And more about this just in a second. And finally, this muscle is unique in its nerve. It is the only muscle in the upper limb or muscles related to the upper limb that is supplied by cranial nerve. So I did mention, are you just about to ask me? This is your brain and spinal cord. Okay. We mentioned 31 pairs of nerves, spinal nerves, and we talked about them in details. Okay. All our muscles certainly would be supplied ultimately by these nerves, brachial plexus. We will talk about it. Today, I'm talking about this nerve coming from your brain. It is a cranial nerve named accessory nerve, raqam 11. We have 12 cranial nerves. Okay. Number 11 is this one, spinal accessory. Okay. So this is the main nerve supply of trapezius with contribution of C3, spinal, cervical spinal nerve, C3 and C4. Now, so let's talk about serratus anterior. This muscle looks like a saw, زي المنشار. بسموها العضلة المنشارية الأمامية. Okay. It takes its origin from the ribs, as you can see. The surface of ribs round number one, number nine, intervening deep fascia, overlying the related intercostal deep fascia. We'll talk about it later on. Okay, يعني ماخذ مش بس من العظم وكمان في فاشيا هناك. I will talk about it next week. طيب, that was the origin. The origin is very, يعني, simple. You can easily understand. You would struggle with the insertion, okay? The insertion, look at this muscle. Now, the lateral border, this is the lateral border, as you can see. This is the lateral border of the scapula. The lateral border has been occupied, especially from its dorsal aspect, by teres minor, teres major, and, of course, infraspinatus taking the infraspinous fossa. So this huge muscle, as it is looking for an insertion, it would come and pass, يعني هيها بتيجي هون, and say hi to the lateral border, and it would find that the lateral border is engaged by muscles, and then it would carry its journey, okay, further, and it would see here a muscle occupying the subscapular fossa, which is subscapularis muscle, subscapularis muscle. And therefore, the serratus anterior won't be attached to the lateral border. It won't be attached to the subscapular fossa. أكيد ما رح تمسك لا في اللاترال ولا في الفوصل, لأنهم occupied, مليانين, معبيين. And therefore, it would say to the subscapular, allow me, I would cross in front of you, okay, and I would be inserted into the superior angle of the scapula, but here on the ventral surface and the medial border of the scapula and the lower border of the scapula, ventrally, okay? The insertion, and you may be confused during your practical session, find the serratus anterior. Go and find, first of all, subscapularis, okay? Identify the lateral border of scapula. Then go and check on the medial border. You would find part of the muscle, especially in this articulated arms. يعني في الأشياء الكاملة لما تكون الإيد لحالها, السيريتس أنتيرو بتكون على الميديال border. Now, The origin, the insertion, then insertion is simple, medial border of the scapula. The origin are from the ribs from 1 to 9. Now, what do you think? The muscle, شو هي الوظيفة تبعت هاي العضلة؟ أول شيء, does this muscle act on the shoulder joint?
No.
So this muscle is designed for the shoulder girdle, especially that it was connected to the medial border of the scapula. هي masculine scapula. So therefore, when you bring the insertion toward the origin, you can do a protraction. هاي بتدفع scapula forward, protraction. Also, it keeps the costal surface of the scapula closely opposed to the thoracic wall. وهي بتعمل contraction, medial border, okay, بضل ملتصق في مين؟ في thoracic wall, not attached, بكون بس closely opposed to it. يعني مش رافع زي ما أفرجيكم إياه كمان شوي. أوكي. طيب, وفي function إلها لما ترجع بالسلايدات. أنا حكيت protraction, retraction, medial rotation, lateral rotation, muscles involved. لما تروح هناك رح تقرأ إنه على السلايد هاد طلعه سيريتس أنتيريور. هاي سيريتس أنتيريور, أوكي, وهاي ترابيزيوس. الترابيزيوس ماسكة في السكابولا من الأعلى, مزبوط, ماسكة في الأكروميون, ماسكة في السباين, أوكي, فبتشد مين؟ السكابولا أب, أوكي, والسيريتس أنتيريور ماسكة من الداخل في اللور أنجل, they can rotate mean the scapula, okay? When you need this, when you're raising your arm above your head, okay? إذن serratus anterior و trapezius both participate in the elevating your arm above your hand. By how they achieve this? By just simply rotating the scapula, okay? So تأخرت.
دكتور, يعني serratus anterior تعمل protraction و elevation.
Yes. It's a big muscle, huge muscle. The trapezius اللي بتعمل elevation, the upper fibers. لكن الحركة التنتين مع بعض, they rotate the scapula, لأنه كل واحدة ماسكة في مكان. كل واحدة بتدفع زي ما هو محطوط في الصورة. الآن to conclude the serratus anterior muscle has a unique nerve جاي من C5, C6, C7. We will talk about them next week. هذا العصب اسمه long thoracic nerve. الأعصاب دائما بتمشي تحت العضلات. هذا العصب بيمشي superficial لمين؟ للعضلة, يعني مش تحت العضلة, فوق العضلة. شو هاد؟ You pay the price. Especially in mastectomy. شو يعني mastectomy? Females that suffer from breast cancer, breast CA, okay, سرطان الثدي. When we move the tumor, we get engaged into this area. الجراح بدخل بياخد الليمف نودز, رح نحكي عنهم بعدين, من هاي المنطقة. ف sometimes they injure mean the long thoracic nerve. Injury to the nerve, the muscle is useless. حكينا for a muscle to produce a movement has to be supplied by a nerve. Now if this nerve has been injured, it means that the muscle has been also paralyzed. شلل هاي العضلة سيؤدي إنه it was attaching, inserting itself or attaching itself to the medial border. By contraction, it keeps this border, okay, close to the thoracic cavity. Now it has been paralyzed. The medial border has gone free and it looks like a wing, زي الجناح, okay. هذا المنظر عند الطيور بتشوفوه, like a wing, and of course when you see this you need to know that either the serratus muscle, serratus anterior muscle has been damaged, or the nerve, most likely the nerve of this muscle has been injured. هل المريض هذا رح يكون بيعمل forward protraction؟ أكيد رح تكون والروتيشن تبعت الاسكابلا أكيد it would be affected. طيب بس خلوني هون.